doing, Andy?
Making a mess.
As usual?
Yep. I'm trying to make a hole bigger.
More bigger hole.
More bigger.
What is that hole for?
A new chart plotter. Because Miss Antsy Pants couldn't wait.
I don't know who Miss Antsy Pants is. And it was on sale. You know how much I like sales?
It was on sale.
As in not full price.
Was I on sale?
Yeah, you were a special I got.
Scratch and dent?
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah, that's close enough.
Off a little bit more?
Yeah, not much. I'm close.
There.
now that we put our Garmin in, oh no. Raymarine.
Ooh. Ah.
Now let's see if it powers on. Here we go.
It's broken.
Maybe. I admit when I make mistakes, and well, apparently I don't know how to read, because I was under the assumption 99.9% of marine electronics started from 12 and went up to like 28 volts. Not this guy. He is at 12 volts period. So what we had to do was we got a converter that takes 24 volts down to 12 volts. So now it's hard to see.
Is the chart plotter switch on?
Yes. It just doesn't like my finger sometimes. So now that it actually has 12 volts provided to it, it's starting up. And this is a Raymarine Axiom 9 RV for Real Vision. We don't use the Real Vision. It was just deep discount on sale. That's why we got it.
I think they got that part from my video about how you started this before you were way ready to do it.
We also have the Raymarine Phantom Doppler 2 radar, which is kind of cool. We'll show you that here in a minute. So, the charts, we'll pull those up. So being that the NMEA network is plugged into this, it sees the transducers. We have 9.9 feet of water from the transducer, so it's about 11 feet of water from the surface. I've got to put the differential in there. The water temp is 73.2. This shows us where we are. We can zoom in. Shows us right here on our slip.
But it works.
It does work. So we can go home and go to radar. We'll try to turn it on.
What do you mean try?
If I didn't screw it up.
Is she finicky?
Yeah, you could say she is finicky.
Gotta rub her right.
An old woman taking new parts doesn't like it sometimes.
No, she don't.
So, with this, if we had some bigger boats out, which I don't see we do. Okay, there it is. So we're gonna transmit. And there's our radar sweep. So that's working. Cool part about it is we go to the charts. See if I know how to do this. I don't know how to do this. So supposedly we can do the radar sweep on top of the, that's not what I wanted. We can do the radar sweep on top of the charts. We can do the split screens. So you see the radar over here, as well as, and you can see right here, these like hits are the pylons for the bridge that's beside us. Another cool thing we can do, we can go to apps,
and hit Victron. And this is now showing us the stats of the boat. And what the inverter is doing, shore power versus solar and everything else. Another thing we can do is hit this. We've got a Fusion stereo hooked up to it.
Say what?
So we can actually jam the tunes while we're sailing, which would be kind of cool. But I don't have the speakers hooked up. But it is a Fusion radio with a JL 600 watt amplifier going into, it's going to be temporarily four JL M3 6.5-inch speakers. Well, two of them. Those are soon going to be four M6 7.7 JLs. We're going to have some audio on this boat. So this is kind of cool that, you know, we can change the radio stations. And what I've done is our Valspar splitter for the AIS and VHF has an FM output of it. So I ran that into the stereo. So our FM antenna is 60 some feet up the mast. So we should hear about anything and everything. So I think we're good to go. We got a chart plotter working. The only other thing we need is a couple other things done, and let's go have some fun. What do you say, Nancy?
Can we talk dates on when we could leave? Yeah.
You can talk all you want now. So, until next time, guys. Bye.